you know that missionaries serve out in these remote locations, but have you ever thought about how a missionary gets to where they're going? The answer to that is the missionary aviation specialist. That is the link for the missionary to the outside world and to those vital supplies that they need.
My name is Jason Schwab, and I serve with New Tribes Mission. I flew in the Philippines. The region that I was working on is an island region, and the typhoon took out a lot of the boats. And so we repositioned one of our helicopters and some of our airplanes. Some of the bigger organizations were over in the eastern Philippines meeting those major needs, but there were still the smaller places that were overlooked that we were able to fill that niche and meet an immediate need.
We train people to be missionary pilots, to be bush pilots in foreign countries, to humanitarian aid or missions organizations, to do relief work with the tool of aviation. A lot of missions organizations who want and are looking for pilots coming out of Moody send pilots of their own that have been in the mission field and are experienced back to Moody to teach a younger generation.
Having someone on loan really helps because I've been overseas and I've seen what it's like to work in the remote province of a developing country. I have to buy my own fuel, I have to maintain my hangar, I have to maintain my airplane. I was a single pilot program, so I really had to be a jack of all trades to keep the program going there.
There are many places that can teach you to fly, but because of that day one attitude that you're going to be overseas, responsible for this airplane and serving missions, Moody does an excellent job.
It's a very, very small subset of the aviation community in the United States that would be able to qualify for the type of person we're looking for. And Moody is very instrumental in turning out that kind of a person.
An instructor here at Moody Aviation, whether they're hired by Moody or whether they're serving us on loan from one of their mission organizations, they feel the responsibility to train up missionaries. And you don't just train missionaries technical skills, you train them heart skills.
My job is more than just teaching them how to fly, it's teaching them what it means to be a missionary pilot. And there's a lot involved, and it has more to do with your walk with Christ than anything else.
It's a 5-year program from Bible school through 2 years of maintenance and mechanics to 2 years of flight training.
My name is Zach Merkling. I'm a first-year Moody Aviation student, and I'm from Spokane, Washington. As of now, I'm just finishing up a lot of my biblical classes, because going onto the mission field, if you're going to be a missionary, you should have a good grasp of biblical knowledge. The flying doesn't happen until the 4th year, and sometimes it's a little bit of a deal breaker for some of my peers that have dropped out. But I think it's really good because first you get a solid grounding in your biblical knowledge, and then you get the maintenance part. So you learn how to take care of your planes before you fly them, and then you get to fly them and you're doing basically all 3 of those combined at the same time during 4th and 5th year.
My name is Alfred Olsen. I'm from Sweden. I grew up as a missionary kid in Nepal, where my dad worked as a surgeon. So it's always been in my life. Democratic Republic of Congo has like just been on my mind. It's a long time till I get to go out and actually do it, so we'll see where the needs are.
For years 2 and 3, the students are here at the AMT hangar. Whether you're a flight major or a maintenance major, a student is going to spend those 2 years earning their AMP certificate. And that basically qualifies them to do basic maintenance and troubleshooting on general aircraft.
My name is Dusty Williams. I'm a 3rd year maintenance specialist. The reason I came to Moody was I wanted a Bible school where I could learn and develop my faith, and also get the technical side. It really takes a lot of dedication and commitment. It's a great program and it's intense, so you have to be prepared mentally and physically to come and enjoy the work.
After that, the student will choose either a flight or a maintenance major and begin to work through curriculum in an advanced setting for maintenance.
I made a decision to become a maintenance specialist because I really felt that that's the way that God had gifted me. And I wanted to have that training so that when I got to the field, I could serve the pilots in the best way possible. As a 4th year student, we are learning to do the major sheet metal repair so that when we're on the field and an aircraft has a crack from landing on rough strips or maybe is damaged in a small accident that we can repair it and get it back onto the flight line as quickly as possible.
If they're a flight major, the student will begin by working to earn their private pilot certificate, and after that begin to transition to some high performance and complex aircraft, and then work also towards earning their instrument rating and their commercial rating by the time they graduate their fifth year.
Every year built up, and by the last 2 years, it is a very, very demanding program.
It's beginning the transition into larger aircraft, high performance and complex airplanes, which are the ones that we use on the missions field.
I'm a fifth year flight student. This semester we're working through instrument training, and immediately following the completion of that course, we will be transitioning into the last month or so of commercial training, in which we would graduate in May with a commercial pilot certificate with an instrument rating. Moody is unique in the sense that they allow training into marginal airstrips, in which maybe some other smaller schools or schools that are geared towards missionary aviation maybe don't allow. And so flying the airplanes that we are most likely to fly overseas, training in areas which we are most likely to fly in overseas. It is exciting to learn what the missions are teaching, so that there's really a seamless transition between training and real world.
My name is Eleanor Hansen, and I'm in the fifth year of the flight training here at Moody. In flight, they stretch you to a whole nother level. They really do make sure you have a wide range of knowledge, not only in maintenance skills, but flight skills. And then they send you through basic life support and wilderness advanced training. So they really do want you to be well-rounded and prepared. I would love to be a part of an organization and help that organization and missionaries by supporting them in whatever way I can.
Currently, I have the privilege and opportunity of serving here at Moody, at my alma mater, and I'm with them for the next 2 years. And so I get to work as a flight instructor and also as a production mechanic with Moody. After that, my wife and I are looking at serving somewhere overseas. I was really encouraged by some of the things that I got to go through, the Bible training, the maintenance portion before we get to flight. Moody kind of forces you to take pride in what you do and to do it well and do it with excellence.
Moody Aviation starts from ground zero to train you towards mission flying. From stem to stern, it is guided and geared towards training you to be able to serve cross-culturally.
The Moody program is definitely for someone who has a heart to serve and the drive and the desire to do that in a professional manner and to put in the effort and to pay the costs of what it's going to take to really do this job well.
Moody exists to train missionary pilots. That's why we're here.
Those are the first responders to those villages. Those are the ones that bring aid in and out. Those are the ones that are the lifeline, that are the communication to the outside world from those villages.
As we look out to the world around us, we don't see that missionary aviation is going to disappear very soon at all.
I'm looking forward to just seeing how these students go on to serve. It's been amazing to see where some of them have already ended up and to know that I've been a part of them getting there. I know there is a lot to be done because there's still a lot of places that need the help that we're able to give.